If you're creating regular content for social media, you'll want to be using a scheduling tool. Not only does it allow you to post content across multiple channels, but it helps you plan ahead, scheduling automatic posts to occur during the optimal time. Canva allows you to create your designs and schedule them all in one. And once it's up, you track impressions, clicks, likes, even comments with our performance analytics. Are you ready to take your social game to the next level? Stick around and I'm going to show you how. My name's Lachlan and I am a social media lead here at Canva. I can't wait to show you how easy it is to use the content calendar and talk through some of its benefits. But before we get started, take a second to subscribe to our channel for more incredible how-to videos like this one. Okay, if you're watching this, there's a good chance you're already using Canva to create beautiful graphics and videos for your social channels, especially if you run a side hustle or business. Traditionally, the next step is downloading your designs and then uploading them to the platform or your scheduling tool. Scheduling tools are a content creator's dream. They help you plan, manage, even post automatically so your content can stay on track. Having a content planner built into Canva means you can do it all in one space, saving you time so it's a seamless transition between designing and posting. In this video, I'll show you how to plan content without leaving Canva, connect social media accounts, publish designs straight to social, and track engagement on published posts. Before we go any further, it's worth mentioning the content planner is part of the Canva Pro bundle. This gives you access to tools like the background remover and magic resize. There is a free 30-day trial so you can test all the pro features for yourself. Okay, let's jump into Canva. On the homepage, click on Content Planner. This will bring you to a calendar screen where all your social media content planning will happen. You'll notice that popular social media days are already in there from all around the world, including International Women's Day and National Pancake Day, my personal favorite. These are perfect for giving you ideas about possible posts. If you prefer to remove these, just head to the Filters button and uncheck the Social Media Holidays box. You can also add regional holidays for where you are, along with cultural events too. I tend to have all of these turned on so I never forget an important date, which means no more last minute scrambles to get something up before anyone realizes you forgot. Now, before we get started on scheduling a post, I'll show you how to connect your social media accounts. Click the three dots here and select Connect Social Account. You'll then see a list of all the accounts that you can connect to. It's possible to connect to more than one account for each platform. On the Pro plan, your whole team can access the Content Planner as well, enabling them to create, view, and schedule posts to your calendar. You can add members here and choose which channels to grant access to. So there's absolutely no need to try and manage your social content calendar all on your own. Teamwork makes the dream work. All right, now we're ready to schedule some content. Head back to the content planner and click the plus sign on any date in your calendar. From here, you can browse through your recent projects or start a new design from scratch. If you're using an existing design, simply click on it, select the channel you want to post to, the design pages you want to post, and add your caption. You can either schedule it right away or save it as a draft for later. And if you change your mind, there's always the option to edit or delete your post. Next, I'll show you how to add a brand new design to your content planner. But before I do, I'd love to know if this is making sense. What kind of impact do you see the content planner having on your business? Drop us a comment below. Okay, as promised, let's see how to work with a new design in the content planner. You'll want to click New, then hit Post, and this time I'm going to start with one of these templates. There are thousands to choose from, which makes creating content so much easier. Plus, they can all be resized to work with the platform you're posting to. And if you want to start with a completely blank one, you can. I'm going to work with this template here. Click on it and it will open up as a new project for me. I'm going to make a few changes to the design by adding in some different text and changing the color scheme. Now, it's ready to be scheduled. All I have to do now is click the share button here, then share on social. Click the channel you want to share it to, then all that's left to do is add a caption, edit the date if needed, and schedule your post or save it later. Simple, right? You might be thinking, that's great and all, but your current social media tools also give you great analytics on performance as well. Well, Canva has this covered too. Once your post has gone up, it will appear as a published post in your content planner. All you've got to do is click on it and tap insights. This will give you stats on your impressions, clicks, likes, and even comments, so you can stay on top of what's working and what needs tweaking. Canva's content planner truly is the all-in-one tool you need to create and publish content. But hold on, that's not all. If you're the kind of person who loves to visualize what their social feed is going to look like before you post, I've got a brilliant hack for you to do this. Just open up on the homepage, search for Instagram Grid Planner, and select this one. Every picture here is a frame so you can drag and drop posts in and plan your schedule visually. It's such an easy way to make sure your feed looks the way you want. I keep this open as a separate tab when I'm filling in my content planner so I remember where everything is supposed to go. Well, I hope this video has given you a great intro to Canva's content planner and inspired you to give it a go. For me, it means I can design everything when I have a spare second or two, normally on a Sunday afternoon, and schedule it, knowing it will post at the perfect time for my audience. It's set and forget, and I can start focusing on the next thing. If you found this video helpful, go ahead and give it a like or subscribe to our channel to get plenty more videos like this. And if you've started using the content planner already, drop a comment below and let me know how it's going. We really want it to be a seamless experience, so let us know if there's anything we can do to make it better. Thanks for watching.